nothing like a dame. The Oscar goes to Dame Judi Dench.
This was the first of many successes for Shakespeare in Love. Last year, Dame Judi missed out on the Best Actress category for Mrs. Brown.
I feel for 8 minutes on the screen, I should only get a little bit of him.
Next up, Best Actress, and again, Shakespeare in Love wins through. Gwyneth Paltrow clearly overcome. She could barely get through her speech.
I would not have been able to play this role had I not understood love of a tremendous magnitude, and for that I thank my family.
And then the big one, Best Picture.
Shakespeare in Love. David Harbin, Donna Gelati, Harvey Weinstein.
In all, the film picked up 7 Oscars, the biggest single winner on the night. Saving Private Ryan won 5 awards, including Best Director for Steven Spielberg. But it was Italian actor-director Roberto Benigni who really went for it when he got Best Foreign Film. And then he surprised everyone by winning Best Actor.
This is a terrible mistake because I used up all my English. No, I don't know.
At the after-show party, Dame Judi seemed happy to share her newly acquired statuette.
Well, it's when Robin Williams said Dame.
All in all, it's been a good night for the Brits. Charlie State, Hollywood. 5 News.
Can I keep this?
You bet.
The Home Secretary Jack Straw tonight intervened to stop the early release of Brighton bomber Patrick McGee and 3 other IRA terrorists. McGee, who carried out the 1984 bombing of the Grand Hotel in Brighton, was due to be released in June. A government spokesman said the decision to block this was not related to the Good Friday Agreement on early releases. Northern Australia is picking up the pieces after a battering from Cyclone Vance. One man's missing and more than 100 houses have been destroyed. 140 mile an hour winds ravaged towns and heavy rain causing widespread flooding. Vance is the worst cyclone in the area in 25 years. Football now, and England's crucial Euro 2000 qualifier against Poland is just 5 days away, but Kevin Keegan's squad has some serious injury worries. Here's Trisha Dudu.
Liverpool's boy wonder Michael Owen heads England's crocks list. His persistent hamstring injury has been slow to respond to treatment and he's struggling for Saturday. But Man United's David Beckham is expected to make it despite being pulled off yesterday with a problem calf. But Leeds' David Batty has pulled out with flu, together with Andy Hinchcliffe, who has a back injury. And after his controversial call-up, Chris Sutton may not even play after picking up a groin injury at the weekend. But good news for Ian Walker. Fresh from his side's Worthington Cup victory, the Spurs keeper has been drafted in as cover for injured Nigel Martin.
Controversy over Lennox Lewis's fight with Evander Holyfield just won't go away. The World Boxing Union claims it sacked the judge who scored the fight as a win for Holyfield more than a year ago. Meanwhile, the heavyweights have signed up for a $30 million rematch in September. The round-the-world balloonists today told how they beat a fuel crisis to win their place in the history books. British co-pilot Brian Jones said they were running dangerously low on fuel when the balloon suddenly picked up speed. He said it was as if an invisible hand was guiding them.
50 to 60 to 70 to 80 to 90 knots. And at that point, I just pushed the calculations away and knew we didn't need them anymore.
Well, let's take a quick look at tomorrow's weather then. Wind and patchy rain in the north, mainly cloudy and dry in the south, with the odd shower in some places. Top temperatures, well, between 5 and 7 degrees tomorrow. That's it from me for now. We're back with another update at 10:45. Have a good evening. Bye for now.
Starring Reservoir Dogs' Mr. Blonde, Michael Madsen, Executive Target. The network premiere, Thursday at 9 on 5.
Monster Mania is coming to 5, and here's a few rules on staying alive.
Rule 1.
At the sound of an ominous thud, always open the door.
Can't you believe me?
Rule 2.
If you're running from unspeakable evil, never look where you're going.
Rule 3.
Always answer the call of nature if you're stuck in a swamp.
1 minute he was taking a whiz by the tree, and the next second, zip!
Four.
Remember, beauty is only skin deep.
Strangers in the night.
You're a plant.
Two lonely people, we were strangers in the night.
Rule 5.
The most important of all.
Don't let them get wet.
Never ever obey the rules.
really bad feelings about all of this.
Monster Mania, this weekend on 5. You know you'll watch, don't you?
Sport of every sort, live and dangerous, 12:30. Meanwhile, cop a load of Bronson in another movie premiere. And Channel 5 has given this one a C for caution rating because it contains adult material.
BBC Three now in a story of racial tension in the Deep South based on the work of John Grisham. An all-star BAFTA tribute to Victoria Wood on BBC One, and here on BBC Two, a country legend. It's Hank Williams.
The last thing I remember is seeing one of the girl's foot come down onto my face, and then that was it. I was blacked out. You had bruises on my legs, my back, my chest, everywhere. I always ended up with bruises somewhere on my body.
A 14-year-old girl, stripped on the school playground by a group of 15 bullies, made to kneel down, begged for her clothes. Photographs are taken and circulated around the school.
On camera one, coming to two next.
How much advertising space are you selling now?
If I can refer to my business plan.
Unless it's in your head right now, and you absolutely know that, I'm not going to put my money and trust you with my money unless you know that like that. Boom. If you really believe that I'm going to make money, you're going to look me straight in the eye now and you're going to tell me how I'm going to do it.
I mean, I don't know what more I can say to you. The words aren't coming to me. The business works.
Stand by studio. On air.
Anita was taken into care at 14 when her mother's relationship with her stepfather broke down. At 16, she was housed in a bed and breakfast in Consett and started shoplifting.
The easiest thing for me to do was to go out shoplifting, go thieving, just anything to make the money to get by, because I was making more money shoplifting than I would have working.
8:35.
Okay, now.
Second verse, said Dylan. Slow movement.
Dylan the Rabbit was named after Bob Dylan, which gave rise to the most enduring myth about the series, that everyone was on drugs.
Yes, that is a modern myth, because we met all the university students who said, oh yes, early drug culture. Absolutely not. Isn't it interesting how we put our own spin on things?
That's a relief, panted Dougal.
All the pain and heartache of country music's first superstar, now on BBC Two, and how it all came to a tragically early end. Arena on Hank Williams.
Story continues tomorrow at 1:25 and 6. Meanwhile, next this evening, it's Central News.
Did you think the World Cup final was exciting?
No? Well, here's some real excitement. The world's favourite quiz show with the big, big prizes. Wheel of Fortune, the game everybody likes to play for big, big money. What's it called again?
The all-new Wheel of Fortune.
Don't miss it.
Make a date with Wheel of Fortune Mondays at 8 on Central.
Arlie's just had 6 tuplets.
Baby boom.
Whoa. Ow.
Baby talk.
I'm talking watching them grow.
Their first day at school.
First kiss.
The first choc ice.
First Easter egg.
Baby food.
These are children, Petra. Don't think I've assessed the need for taste and subtlety.
We'll pay 20,000 for the serialisation rights and an extra 5 for the makeover story.
I just want it to be over!
Baby blues for the baby-faced Frank Stubbs. Tonight at 9 on Central.
Also tonight, but a little later, Toronto is the setting for our courtroom drama, Street Legal, at 10:40.
Now you can get that airy scent of spring in a washing up liquid, because now there's new Spring Fresh Fairy. So you get that wonderful spring fresh feeling every time you wash up. New Spring Fresh Fairy. Spring bottled.
It's new. It's here. It's RoboCop the ride at the American Adventure theme park. Drive carefully.
My insurance service gave me an excellent quote. How was that? Nice and easy. That was the big decider. My insurance service didn't just give me a cheaper quote. There were loads of other things thrown in as well. I think that's important. It was good to have that. They're very helpful, very nice. Makes me feel good.
His insurance service, the insurance service. Why not make us your insurance service? Call free on 0800 989898 and find out how much you could save.
The incentive we got was a free torch, still working.
Nivea Sun.
Now for sensitive skins, new Nivea Sun Sensitive with active cell protection against UVA and UVB. It's water resistant and hypoallergenic, so even sensitive skins can have fun in the sun. Because Nivea Sun makes the sun safer.
Unraveling bureaucracy. Exploding myths. Turning over corruption. Dissolving mysteries. World in Action, bringing stories to light.
The World in Action team reports this evening at 8:30. It's time now for the latest Central News.
Hit by lightning, lovers struck down in electrical storms. Face to face, objectors to waste tip quarrel over a quarry. And unclaimed cash, millions in benefits are going begging.
Hello, good evening. It's the weather that makes the headlines tonight because electrical storms have been causing havoc across this region. One man has died, another is seriously hurt. Several people have been lucky to escape with their lives.
A four-year-old boy from Shropshire cheated death by inches when a lightning bolt crashed through his bedroom. Hundreds of homes were flooded and were without electricity during the storms. Emergency services say they were hard-pressed to cope.
25-year-old Stephen Lockley was killed outright after being struck by a bolt of lightning at a Shropshire beauty spot. Stephen, a computer programmer, had been out walking near Stiperstones in the Shropshire Hills with his fiancée Joanne Goodall when the electrical storm broke. Joanne raised the alarm by using a motorist mobile phone. It took ambulance men 40 minutes to walk to the spot where the tragedy had happened.
It's really sudden. We thought we'd had enough time to go down the hill. We thought, oh, it's gone its way or something. We'll go down the hill quick and then we'll be all right.
So it just hit him?
Well, I don't know. Yeah, it was a big explosion. Somebody said it might have bounced off the rock and hit him, but it was all, you could see the state of his clothes and that. It was as if it had been in a bomb or something.
You can't avoid it, can you? Because for some reason it happens and we don't know that reason, do we?
In Staffordshire, a man on a canal holiday with his family was struck by lightning on a boat near Rugeley. He was saved by a passing fire officer who gave him first aid. 37-year-old Richard Parsonage from Nottingham is now said to be poorly but stable in Staffordshire District General Hospital.
Thankfully, one of our officers was on duty at the time and was in attendance when this was happening. He carried out resuscitation on the gentleman and radioed to us here for an appliance from Rugeley that has the equipment on there for further resuscitation.
During the storms, emergency services all over the region were stretched to the limit, with homes being flooded and buildings damaged. Four-year-old Tom Morgan from Ludlow missed death by 4 inches when a bolt of lightning crashed through the wall of his bedroom. It blew him and his bed across the room. The electricity finally earthed itself through a radiator. And in Barton under Needwood, members of a church choir had to be evacuated when lightning struck the pinnacle of the church tower, dislodging a half hundredweight block of stone. It was later made safe by the Fire and Rescue Service.
Other news, furious campaigners today halted a council visit to a quarry which may become a rubbish dump. There were heated exchanges between councillors and objectors, and plans to go onto the site had to be abandoned.
The councillors arrived at the quarry to find the